See him. So, whatever.
I'm glad you made it, Inquisitor. I fear they've already started the ritual.
Blood magic, I'd wager. You can smell it. Or see the corpses. You take point. I'll guard your backs.
Hawk, you suck. You can't guard nothing. Did you even play your game? Uh-oh.
Wait! No!
Warden Commander Clarell's orders were clear.
This is wrong!
Remember your oath. In war, victory. In peace, vigilance. In death.
I'm sorry.
Sacrifice. Good. Now bind it just as I showed you.
Wait, are they becoming abominations on purpose? Uh-oh. This is some sick shit.
What an unexpected pleasure. Lord Livius Edamond of Virantium, at your service.
You are no warden.
But you are. The one Clarell let slip. And you found the Inquisitor and came to stop me. Shall we see how that goes?
It looks like you've already done some of my work for me.
What, him? We simply needed his blood. Sympathy. Maybe make the wardens feel a bit of remorse. Wardens, hands up. Hands down.
Corypheus has taken their minds.
They did this to themselves. You see, the calling had the wardens terrified. They looked everywhere for help.
Even to Vinta.
Yes. And since it was my master who put the calling into their little heads, we in the Venatori were prepared. I went to Clarell full of sympathy, and together we came up with a plan. Raise a demon army, march into the deep roads, and kill the old gods before they wake.
That actually is a pretty good story.
Corypheus marching across Orlais with an army of demons. I was shown that back at the Seeker Fortress.
And now you know how it begins. Sadly for the Wardens, the binding ritual I taught their mages has a side effect. They are now my master's slaves. This was a test. Once the rest of the Wardens complete the ritual, the army will conquer Thedas.
So Corypheus influenced the Wardens and made them do this ritual?
Made them? No! Everything you see here, the blood sacrifices to bind the demons, the Wardens did it of their own free will. Fear is a very good motivator, and they were very afraid.
That's a lie. The Grey Wardens are heroes. They would never do this willingly.
The Grey Wardens care about nothing save stopping blights. They will do anything to accomplish that. You should have seen Clarell agonize over the decision. Burdens of command, I suppose.
Why would Clarell risk using demons?
Demons need no food, no rest, no healing. Once bound, they will never retreat, never question orders. They are the perfect army to fight through the deep roads. Or across Orlais. Now they are bound to my master.
Do you really want to see the world fall to the Blight? What do you get out of this?
The Elder One commands the Blight. He is not commanded by it, like the mindless Darkspawn. The Blight is not unstoppable or uncontrollable. It is simply a tool.
Somebody's certainly a tool.
As for me, while the Elder One rules from the Golden City, we, the Venatori, will be his god kings here in the world.
I already know the answer to this, but...
Why would the Wardens try to kill the old gods?
A blight happens when Darkspawn find an old god and corrupt it into an archdemon. If someone fought through the deep roads and killed the old gods before they could be corrupted... Woof! No more blights. Ever. The Wardens sacrifice their lives and save the world.
That's madness. For all we know, killing the old gods could make things even worse.
Well then, it's a good thing I'm taking this demon army off their hands.
Solas does have a weird point, I guess. You're dead.
That's all I needed to know.
Oh, please. The Elder One showed me how to deal with you in the event you're foolish enough to interfere again. That mark you bear, the anchor that lets you pass safely through the Veil, you stole that from my master. He's been forced to seek other ways to access the Fade. When I bring him your help, his gratitude will be...
No! What a jump!
Kill them!
Kill them! Kill them! Oh! Oh, you getting fucked up, son?
So, that went well. You were correct. Through their ritual, the mages are slaves to Corypheus.
And the Warden warriors? Oh, of course. It's not real blood magic until someone gets sacrificed.
Erimund lied to the Wardens. They were trying to prevent future blights.
With blood magic and human sacrifice.
The Wardens were wrong, Hawk. But they had their reasons.
All blood mages do. Everyone has a story they tell themselves to justify bad decisions. And it never matters. In the end, you are always alone with your actions.
I believe I know where the Wardens are, Your Worship. Erimund fled in that direction. There's an abandoned Warden fortress that way. Adamant.
Good thinking.
The Warden and I will scout out Adamant and confirm that the other Wardens are there. We'll meet you back at Skyhold.